The remains of the late President Fidel V. Ramos have arrived at the Libingan ng Mga Bayani. Our correspondent Sherry Ann Torres now joins us on the line to tell us more about what we can expect today. Sherry Ann, over to you.
Yes, Carmina, attendees for the interment of former President Fidel Ramos are now starting to arrive here at Section A, or the area dedicated for the demise presidents of the Philippines. Those who are witnessing the former president's interment are just waiting for the arrival of his remains as well as his family, and they are now occupying the ready tent beside and in front of his would-be gravesite. Given its distance from the Heroes Memorial Gate, a vehicle is being provided to transport the attendees to Section A. According to Colonel Sirces Trinidad, the Army spokesperson, the Libingan ng Mga Bayani Gate is now closed in preparation for the start of ceremonies. Meanwhile, here at the gravesite, honor guards have already polished. There would be action for the actual ceremony, which is expected to commence here at 11:30 in the morning. At 10 today, FDR's remains already left the Heritage Park, and his urn, carried by a hearse, is expected to arrive here at 10:30 in the morning, where he will be given full military honors. His urn will be transferred in a caisson or carriage to be followed by a procession straight to the area. As expected, people entering the Libingan ng Mga Bayani are required to undergo a number of security checks, and this includes the presentation of their negative RT-PCR test and vaccination card. As of this hour, Carmina, the weather here is, the surrounding here is starting to get dark, promising a possible rain, but people are just waiting for the arrival of the remains of FDR, and rain or shine, the interment will commence. Carmina?
Were you able to see, have you been able to see the final resting place of the former president?
Yes, Carmina. Actually, I'm just in front of this would-be tomb. And this, I don't know if you are seeing this, Carmina, but as of there's already a red carpet for the family of FDR and his other relatives and guests. And the plants here surrounding the area, according to some staff of Ramos Peace and Development Foundation, actually come from former First Lady Ming Ramos. And these plants will serve as the so-called guards of the former president when he is finally laid to rest here in this section of the Libingan ng Mga Bayani.
Thanks a lot, Sherry Ann Torres there, joining us on the line. Manolo, yet another show of love, a testament of love from the former First Lady to her late husband, having those plants surrounding him at any given time, just to stand guard. Manolo.
And here you see the remains of the president being taken out of the hearse and being borne on the shoulders of the honor guard, who will then bring it and place it on the artillery caisson, which will then mark the beginning of the funeral march to the burial site. There will be, of course, the rendering of honors again. In many ways, this is like a relay. So you had the first taking of the custody of the remains at Heritage. Now the arrival at Libingan ng Mga Bayani, where it is now going to be placed on the artillery caisson. They are marching at the funereal pace. Then, with the escort of all the armed services, it will be brought by the funeral procession to the burial site. Again, there will be honors and the final salute, and the giving of the flag to the former First Lady.
Manolo, moments from now, we will be witnessing the firing of a 105mm howitzer cannon. What is the significance of that?
Well, I mean, that's a 21-gun salute. It will be fired 21 times. You're more used to seeing rifles.
Right.
But in this case, as a former president and as a former commander-in-chief, this is really the way to do it. So here they are. So they're going to place it on the mobile platform for the rendering of the honors. And then after that, after the honors have been rendered, they will then transfer it once more to the artillery caisson. Then you will have the formal, the march with bands and the contingents from the different armed services.
Let's take a moment now to just take it all in.